Hello students, so today we are going to study about the verbal hypothesis. We know very well that genetic code is triplet in nature and messenger RNA is having the genetic code. So we say messenger RNA is bringing the genetic information for protein formation. And you know, proteins means sequence of amino acid. Now, who will bring the amino acids? It is the transfer RNA, which is also known as adapter molecule, which is also known as soluble RNA. Will pick up the amino acid and will bring it to the site of the ribosomes where the translation is going on. Now, as we know, there are how many codons we have already studied? The total codons were 64. And each codon is triplet, means made up of three nitrogenous bases. And out of the 64 codon, 61 codon codes for amino acid. Which are only 20 in number. And 3 codons were stop codons. So now we have to emphasize here in this line, that when there are 61 codons are there, and they are coding for only 20 amino acids. And you know, amino acid will be brought to the place with the help of transfer RNA. Then do we require 61 transfer RNA or what? So this was the doubt in the mind of the scientist. Ki how many transfer RNA are required? So Crick observed that transfer RNA required are less than the 61 in number. Then it was asked, thought, ki how come the less than 61 transfer RNA, we are able to make all the translation work very efficient. You know very well, ki messenger RNA contains codon. Okay. And to read that codon, transfer RNA is having anticodon. So transfer RNA is having anticodon to read the codon and it is also bringing the amino acid. Now see the diagram. Let us assume this is your messenger RNA 5'-3' and this is a sequence of the nitrogenous base. I'm just using this one codon only. And you know very well triple U codes for phenylalanine. Then see the transfer RNA diagram. So obviously this will be third end and this will be fifth end. Is it clear? Then here opposite to this, it will be A. Here also A and here also A. So they will do complementary base pairing. This is the way how they read it and they finally transfer their amino acid which they are carrying at the third end. So here your phenylalanine is attached. So these are your codons, okay, these set of three is codon, which is present on messenger RNA. And these are your anticodons, which is present on transfer RNA. Now see, what do you mean by verbal position? Understand the verbal position, try to understand, see here. See, this is your codon, okay? WC, okay? This is your messenger RNA. Please focus here. This is your messenger RNA, WC. And this is your anticodon, AG. The complementary is going on, okay? Now, if suppose I substitute at the third position of the codon, nitrogenous base, I'm substituting C with you. Check the board carefully. I've substituted C with U, okay? This substitution is done. codon is actually changed, but still I am finding same anticodon is coming. Still same anticodon is coming, and I am finding same phenylalanine is attached. And the reason behind it, if you can understand, if you know, the first two nitrogenous bases of the codons are important in the complementary base pairing. And the third position, which is if you change, then also the same amino acid is coming, means degeneracy of codon is useful for saving the transfer RNA. That is why we want less than the 61 transfer RNA for coding all the 20 amino acids, which are coded by 61 codon. Are you understanding what I'm trying to say? Just once again, I'll repeat what I said. There are 61 codon for only 20 amino acid. It means one amino acid is coded by more than one codon. For example, we have already discussed that phenylalanine can be coded by two types of codons, UUU and UC. Few amino acids are having up to six codons. So if first two are not changing and you are doing at the change at the third position, then also same amino acid will come. And this is helping us for the transfer RNA to use the less transfer RNA for the 61 codons. Now see another type. Suppose this is your codon, 5-UUA. Okay, the anticodon is, obviously you know very well that when the messenger RNA is having A, then transfer RNA will have U, it will not have thymine. So it is having this one. Now if you are substituting A with the G, you have done the substitution, means you have done the mutation, but still the right amino acid is coming. So that is explaining the degeneracy of the codon, or you can say it is a wobble position. This is position is known as wobble position, and it is also helping us to lead with the silent mutation. Is it clear? This wobble position is leading to the silent mutation. Now see here, we say codon degenerate. Remember, codon degeneration means one amino acid can be coded by more than one codon. So we say codon degenerate. Crick proposed. What he proposed? He proposed the wobble hypothesis. According to him, if there are 61 codons specifying for amino acid, the cell, they were thinking it might be having 61, okay? But actually what they found, the number of the transfer RNA is less than 61. It means the anticodon of transfer RNA can read more than one codon on messenger RNA. And this is an economy of the transfer RNA. We are able to save other transfer RNA. Now see here, if so, which base should be present in the anticodon, and it can code for, it can read which base of the codon. If suppose here base in anticodon is A, it can read the base of the codon U. Okay, and if suppose the base is G, then it can read even U and it can read even C also. Both it can read. If suppose here C is present, then it can read only G. But if suppose U is present, then it can read A and it can read G also. Another unusual base, if you know, this is present in the transfer RNA, that is known as inosine. So this is unusual base, and it can read even A, it can read U also, and it can read even G also. Is it clear? Now see here, if suppose I'm substituting the in the codon C with you, see this set I have tried to explain to you. This is substituted, then also your anticodon will be G only. The G can read at the third position of it. It can read, if suppose G is there, the G in the anticodon can read. See this, it can read C or U. Okay. Now if you see, if suppose the codon I'm substituting A or with the G, this is done substitution in messenger RNA. This is substituted. Okay. Then also your one base of the anticodon, you will be able to read this one. So as a result, it leads to silent mutation. So this position, wobble position, third position, wobble position, leads to silent mutation. I hope this topic has helped you to understand where we find the codons. Means codons are present on messenger RNA and anticodons are present on transfer RNA. So verbal position is helping us to save the number of transfer RNA. We want less than 61 transfer RNA for coding all the 61 to understand all the 61 codons and code for 20 amino acids. I hope it has helped you to learn the concepts properly. Still, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. You can message me your doubts. I'll try to help you out. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel.